Hey, it's Erica. It's May 3rd, and I have another orchid that's about to bloom. So this is a first-time bloomer, so I don't know exactly how long it'll take to open, but it looks like very soon. And this is the name of the orchid, RLZ Akiko Sato Volcano Queen. And I'm not sure why this one has the frilly petals kind of sticking out, but this one looks fine, so I'm not sure what's going on. Again, it's first time bloomer, so I'm excited to see what it will look like. I've only seen pictures online. Hello, it's June 8th, and here's a quick update on these buds. So they've gotten a lot fatter, and let's see if it'll focus. There we go. So I'm not sure why, but this one has had its ruffles sticking out of the bud since it's formed, so you can see what the color of the flower is going to be like. And I thought it was going to be lighter, but you know, this color is pretty too. And yeah, super excited. This will be the first time it will bloom for me, so I'll be back. Hey guys, this is later the same day, and look, it just cracked open. So it looks like it's gonna open very soon then. So I'll check on this first thing tomorrow morning. Good morning, guys. So this is the next morning, and the top sepal, I think, has opened up. Not much else, but it's getting there. Okay, so this is the same day again. And it's about noontime, and look, both buds are opening. So you can take a glimpse of the inside. It looks like it'd be yellowish, and you know, there's a lot of purple or magenta markings. I'm not sure. We'll see when it opens. Look at what I have to greet me this morning. It's a beautiful day, blue skies, and the Cattleya has opened. I love the colors. So it's actually not really yellow, it's more of a bronzy tinge with little veins and speckles, and the lip has a lighter color along the edge, and it's dark in the inside. So yeah, no fragrance, so it's gonna open up a little more. It looks like it's kind of still closed right now, but very pretty. I am very satisfied with this flower, and this one on the left hasn't even opened yet, so stay tuned for that. Hello, so today is the 12th, and you can see that both flowers are opened. The one on the right, you can see the color is deepened to a more reddish color. When it first opened, it was more yellow and bronzy, so you can see the color difference. This one's the newer one that opened. I do detect a slight fragrance in the sun, so it's a morning scent, or it has scent in the daytime, and it's the little kind of a spicy kind of scent. I don't know how to describe it, but I like it. It's not too strong, but yeah, it's really beautiful. Love all the colors, and there's a little bit of detail on the petals with the little speckles of darker red spots. But yeah, I like this flower a lot. I love the yellow in the throat too. Beautiful. And just to show the rest of the plant, it's kind of hard to see, but it's at the pot right there. And it seems to be happy in its spot. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. Hello, today is June 22nd, and here's an update on my Cattleya. So it is very pretty and fragrant during the daylight hours. It's kind of smells like a spicy dessert, like maybe something you eat during Thanksgiving time. It's a lot more orange now than it was originally. Originally it was more bronze tone, so now it's orange, and there's yellow in the throat and bright magenta lip. And yeah, smells great. And right below it, I want to show you this. This is an Oncidium where the spike has been in full bloom. This is actually the third spike. The first one got caught in a leaf and I broke it while trying to get it out. The second one has bloomed and gone, and then this is the third one. This is also fragrant as well. It's more of a floral scent, sweet scent, and it's very reliable bloomer, so it's an easy orchid. The only problem I have is that it has climbing pseudobulbs and I'm not sure what to do with them. So you can see this latest one is really wrinkly because none of the roots are in the media, and not sure what to do. I don't want to divide it because I don't think, you know, the few bulbs at the top are enough, and then I guess maybe I'll sink it down a little bit, burying the older pseudobulbs and try not to get them too deep so they'll rot. I don't know what to do. Let me know what you guys do with climbing pseudobulbs, especially for Oncidiums. I have a couple that climb severely, and others are, I don't know, better behaved. Maybe it's just the specific type of orchid, but I have no idea for this particular one. Yeah, I love fragrant orchids, so this was a good buy. I got this at a Trader Joe's several years ago. I don't forget when, but it's, yeah, a very reliable orchid. And then here's a quick update on this one. This is the very famous Sherry Baby. It smells like chocolate, and that's why it's famous. So it's on its way out. There's blooms falling. And then I have one, two, three growths for future blooms. So hopefully I'll get more than one spike. It had only one spike. It's very long though, this season. And actually I think in the fall it bloomed and it had one spike. But yeah, I love my fragrant orchids. Again, this one is famous for smelling like chocolate. So that's it for this one. It's probably going to be the last video. So hope you guys enjoy. Thanks for watching. And have a great day, guys. Bye-bye.